Good morning, guys. It is Shelly, and I'm here for Business Tip Tuesday. I'm going to give just a minute and let everybody jump on. So when you're on here, go ahead and say hi so I know you're here. We'll give it just a minute and let some people jump on. I'm going to set this up on my computer so I can see you as well. This new update is just so difficult, and it doesn't work on my browser, so I'm using my phone this morning. Good morning, Katrina. Go ahead and say hi when you get here, guys, so I know you are here. This is Shelly, and I am here with Business Tip Tuesday today. Just gonna give about 1 minute, and then we will get going. Hi, Katrina. Hopefully everybody's having a good day. I don't know if it's warm where you guys are with it being Memorial Day weekend coming up. It has been cold and windy here. It's terrible. So I'm hoping that it will kind of pass so we have a good weekend. I'm going to go ahead and get going for those of you that are on here on time. So I want to welcome everybody to the Next Generation Gym Owners Business Tip Tuesday, where we help owners take control of their business, recruit new members, and earn their freedom. Each week, we're going to be bringing you tried and tested business tips to help connect you with people and with profits. I'm Shelly, like I said, and I'm excited to be bringing you this week's Business Tip Tuesday. This week, we're going to be talking about the art of preparation. 2 weeks ago, Melissa spoke on the small things. Too often, we get really overwhelmed with all of the things we have to do. Right? We're business owners. We might work a full-time job. We might be parents. We might be spouses. And the list just goes on and on and on. What happens when we have so many things to do all the time? It leads us to going through some sort of going through the motions or getting stuck in monotony, right? You might know this quote from John Wooden, but you might not know that originally Ben Franklin said, "Failing to prepare is preparing to fail." So today I want to help make sure that you are preparing every week for success. So grab a pen, grab a paper, and jot down these 5 steps that I have that I use week after week to help me prepare to make sure that every week I'm productive and I'm not just going through the motions. All right, step number one, I want you to choose your night. So for me, it's the night, I want you to choose the night before your week begins. So think about your week. In the past, it's always been Saturday night for me because all of our teams and everything begin on Sunday. But this year that's changing and our teams won't start till Monday. So my new night is now Sunday. So I want you to choose the night before your week kicks off. So think about what that is for you. Okay. And for the last 15 minutes before you go to bed every night, this is your preparation time. This is the time that you'll get yourself ready in the right frame of mind and making sure you're on the page to go for the upcoming week. So step number one is to choose your night. Step number two, after you've chosen your night, every week for, like I said, 15 minutes before you go to bed, you're gonna take time to plan out your week. So I take my weekly calendar. I'm good old fashioned. I have a written one you can see in here that I write everything in, that I print out every week for myself. And you're gonna block out all of your events, okay? So what appointments do you have? What conference calls do you need to be on? What events do you have for your kids? Because our kids have to be priority in our stuff. Anything that takes priority, anything that you already have scheduled out for that entire next week, you're gonna stick in your calendar, okay? When you get those in there, you're gonna go through, make sure you're not missing anything. Check all of your appointments, you know, any meetings you have, your coaching time if you still coach. You're gonna just put everything in that takes any type of priority during your week. After you get that done, you're gonna move on to step three and you're gonna move to the front. For me, like I said, I keep mine on just a handy dandy little planner. I have my goals for the week. So I suggest setting 2 to 3 goals that you're gonna work on and focus on for that week. For me, anything more than 2 to 3 just becomes overwhelming and I find that I don't do a really good job of getting things done. So I look on at what are my goals for the week and how do I get those set, right? So for me this week, so I'll give you an inkling into what I'm doing. My goals are catching up on all of our new All-Star enrollments because as we all know, with COVID hitting and things getting a little bit crazy, I'm sure in your gym, at least it didn't mind. So if not in your gym, I'm proud of you. You guys are awesome. some things kind of fell behind, right? We got off track a little bit. So I have to clean up my new All-Star enrollments. I have to clean up our accounts. We still have some credits that we're working on taking care of for people, you know, from competitions that were canceled. And I want to make sure those are all completely done. So going into the new season, nobody is owed anything or feels like we don't feel like we owe them anything. And then number three is getting our new class schedule all completed, making sure we've done through. So those are my three goals for the week. Those are the big things that I need to get done. Okay, so I suggest you every week plan yourself 2 to 3 goals for the week. What are big things that need to be done? Okay, step number four, after you've completed those goals, after you've written them down and been really intentional about what needs to be done with those, your next step is to schedule time back in that calendar that you have of when you're gonna get those things done, right? So it's all good and fun to jot down and say, well, these are the three things that I need to get done this week. But if you are not intentional in how you plan getting those done, they won't get done. Because just like we know, we talked about earlier, with the monotony of everything we have to do, all the things we're responsible for, sometimes if we aren't intentional in how we plan our time, we'll miss that. So step number four is to go back and schedule in the time every day you're gonna work on your goals. If you're a person, which I suggest you are, that has a set time, you know, from 9 to noon every day, I spend 3 hours working on, you know, in my business, really getting things done for my business, whether that's scheduling social media, doing email marketing, whatever it is that you do, you should have that blocked out in your calendar, right? So you're gonna find time with outside of that to work on those little goals. So maybe it's 1 hour every day. For 1 hour every day, I'm gonna focus on my three goals. I try to be really intentional and know, like, for catching up on all of our All-Star enrollments, that's gonna take me 45 minutes to 1 hour. So I will schedule in on Wednesday from 12 to 1 p.m. or whenever it is, I'm just making it times. This is the time that I'm gonna get this done, right? So the more intentional you are with things, guys, the more you are able to get things done and the less you're able to feel like you're taking away time from your family and from everything else because you're able to be really intentional on doing those things. Otherwise, we all know what happens is that we just are going and going and going and we miss things and then at the last minute we're trying to get them all done. Or we're just going and going and going through the motions and then we get to the end of a year and we're like, what the heck, I'm exactly where I was. We haven't grown, nothing's changed. I didn't get anything that I wanted to get done. And here I am stuck still. And I know we've all felt that. Again, if you haven't, I'm really proud of you because you're super awesome. But I know that's, I've felt that in the past. And this system has really helped me with that. So number five, tip number five that I really want you to focus on is plan daily. Okay. So I do on Sunday for my upcoming week, I do all of my week planning. So I block out my meetings, I block out my times, I plan my goals for the week, and I block out my time to work towards my goals. Then every night before I go to bed, the last 10, 15 minutes before I'm done doing anything, I sit down and I evaluate where I am. So for me, I have 5 things that I check myself on. Okay, how did I do on each of those 5 things? Give myself a score, 1 to 10. Okay, next I sit down and I set my tasks for the next day. So we all know there are things that come up, right? That maybe it's something we didn't plan. It's something that, you know, is a littler thing that needs to get done. So I itemize my tasks. I have what I call red tasks that are, these must be done immediately. I have yellow tasks that need to get done pretty quick, but they're not like pressing. And then I have green tasks, which are things that, hey, I really want to do this, but it's not has to be done right now, right? So I prioritize my red, yellow, and green tasks for the next day. And when I start my day, say it's in that 9 to noon time frame that I talked about earlier, the first thing I do is get all of my red tasks done. These are my must-dos. I have to do this tomorrow, right? If I have time, I can work on my yellow tasks or my green tasks, and then I make sure that I've done my daily tasks, whatever those are, because I do have daily tasks that I take care of within myself, right? Looking at my nightly reports from the night before, looking at our financial stuff, all those kind of things that I do consistently. The biggest thing that I really want to share with you guys is the more consistent and the more intentional you are with how you plan your days, the more you're gonna feel like you're getting more done, right? Because you're gonna feel like you were able to mark off things that you did or feel like you got to the end of the week and be able to look back and say, these were my 3 goals and I did them. And guys, there's going to be weeks where you start doing this and you don't get those goals done. right? And this is a learning. This is how we learn. This is just like how we coach our kids, right? We evaluate at the end and say, what did I need to do different? Okay, well, I got too distracted with X, Y, and Z. And that's why I look at it every night. And that's my plan every night. So I always know kind of where I am and where I'm headed. So I'm never just floating along the river. I'm headed in the right place. Because remember, like I said, failing to plan is planning to fail. So I hope that you can work on implementing this into your daily business. And remember that doing things consistently will help you grow and will help your success be much bigger. Thanks for joining us for this week's Business Tip Tuesday. For more information about the Next Generation Gym Owners, all the programs we offer, including our academy and our upcoming virtual conferences, which I really hope you attend, head over to our website at nextgenowners.com. Don't forget to join us every Tuesday right here at 10:15 Central Standard Time for Business Tip Tuesday. And starting this Thursday, you can join us at the same time for our Thriving Thursdays to get ideas for bringing new revenue into your gym and continuing to build profit, guys. I really enjoyed being with you today, and I hope this helps you out. And if you have any questions, feel free to comment in the comments, and I will get back to you soon. You all have a great day, and go out and be intentional reaching those goals. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.